Good morning everyone. Today we are going to start our first online video classes. In this situation, we all are giving you the answers, but we know that you all are having some problems with the explanation part. Because of that thing, we are going to give you some of the chapter's explanation. Hope it will help you. So students, we all have come across the situations in which in a mixture many things are mixed up, and with that mixture our need is also mixed in that. So in that situations, what you are going to do, that all we want is what, that the thing that we need it. So what are the ways exactly that you are going to pick it up, your need from that mixture? So I think that you are getting the idea, the name of the lesson. Okay, so the name of the lesson is what? Separation of substances. So students, in this chapter separation of substances, first we all have to know the meaning of the name of our chapter. Separations, you know only what is the meaning of the separation, to just take away some particles from some another things. And the substances, that is exactly the main part that we all have to know about it. In science, substance has a deep meaning about it. Okay, so the thing is that what is the definition of substance? If someone will ask you, what you are going to say? So substance is not just a very big thing. It's just like any physical thing that can be touched, that can be felt, that can be measured. Okay, these are the things that can be said as substances. They are made up of many elemental particles. What are the elemental particles? As I said to you in the class, that in this whole world is made of, anything is made up of tiny particles. So like that thing only, any substance is made of. So substances are made of many particles, many elemental particles. Now we are going to know about it, like what are the examples of substances. So if you are going to ask me, sir, tell me some of the examples of substances. First of all, I can say you like aluminium, copper, gold. These are the substances only. And instead of that, air is also an example of substance. Now you can get a little bit confused that how air is a substance. So I am going to say you that air is a mixture of many gases. So the gases are also made of what? Tiny particles. So that thing, from that thing you will be able to know that substances are made of one or many particles. Now second thing that we are going to know about, that what are the parts of substances. Let's see. So I am going to write about here substance. Okay, so here substance are basically are of two types. First thing that is known as what? Pure substance. Can you see it? Okay, first thing that is known as pure substance, and second thing that is known as what? A mixture. So it can be, you say this one is impure also, but the thing is that the exact name, that substance are of two types basically. First thing that is known as a pure one, and other thing that is known as mixture one. Now we are going to know about what is pure substances. Pure substances. Okay, so first thing that we are going to know about the pure substance, that you know that everything is made of tiny particles. Like the same thing, pure substances are consist of only one type of particle. Okay, this is the special one. This makes this pure substance special, that pure substances are made of one kind of particles. Suppose if you are going to take examples about it, I am going to give you like copper, like gold is there. Okay, that things, copper, gold, aluminium, anything you can give, you can write. Suppose orm is there also there. Okay, so these are the examples of pure substances. I think you have got the idea of pure substances. I'm repeating this one again, that what is a pure substance? Pure substance is made, it is that kind of substance that are made of only one kind of particle. And I think you have got the idea of what is mixture. Okay, so suppose, what is a mixture now? So mixture is also a substance in which these mixtures are made of two or more kind of substances, but without any chemical reactions is being taking place. Okay, suppose you want the examples of that. What are the examples? First of all, I'm going to write that salt in water. That is the most general one that we always do. Salt in water. Next thing that we make tea only. So that thing also a part of our mixture. Okay. So now again, you know, pure substances, you have got the idea. What are mixtures? Here you have also got the idea. Now we are in the next part that we are going to know about the parts of mixture. Okay, that is not in the book, I am going to write it, that what are the parts of mixture. Suppose mixture. So again, mixture has two parts. First thing that is known as homogeneous one. Homogeneous mixture, and the other part that is known as heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture. Now, you all will be eager to know about that what are homogeneous and heterogeneous. It is not in our book, but still I am going to say you that homogeneous, you know that everything is made of particles, like the same thing, mixture is a combination of substances, but still we have to know about the homogeneous one. In this homogeneous mixture, the particles, the constituent particles that is being present in this one, no? It is exactly uniformly divided towards the whole substance. But in heterogeneous, it is the constituent particles that are present in heterogeneous one, no? It is not exactly uniformly divided. Now you will be confused that what you are going to say uniformly. Uniformly, that means equal quantities in every part of that. Got it? So again, I'm going to say you, what is homogeneous one? Homogeneous mixture, in homogeneous mixture, the constituent particles are exactly distributed in uniformly in that whole area. But in heterogeneous, the constituent particles are not exactly distributed uniformly.